This season's finale was insane, and I guess they had to match last season's finale, but it was a post-credit scene that really shook things up. A confused-looking William is making his way down the forge and comes across his daughter Emily. Well, it can't be his daughter, because he killed the real her in the last episode. So this must be a recreation of her, or just a host with her image. William is confused whether or not this is real, but the host version of Emily reassures him that this is no simulation and begins questioning him for what the show has been calling fidelity, which is just a cool word for making sure he's identical to the human William. The show kind of makes it seem like he was a host this entire time this season, because this William has the same injuries of the human William that went through all those ordeals this season. But no, he was a human for the entirety of this season, up until the post-credit scenes roll out. I'm sure of this because we see the main timeline human William passed out on the beach being attended to for his injuries. The show also made sure to show Emily's corpse among the other dead people on the beach. The William we see go down the elevator to the forge is in a different timeline, a timeline way into the future. William would have run into Bernard if it wasn't the same timeline, but the main timeline's William was injured and never made it down the forge, and instead was rescued and moved to the beach. This future host version of William enters the forge that has been obviously aged. The flooded area has long since been drained. One of the creators herself, Lisa Joy, came out to clarify a lot of the post-credit scene. In an article in The Hollywood Reporter, she says, "What we see in the end recontextualizes a little bit of that. A lot of that did happen in the timeline, but something else has occurred too, in the far, far future. The world is dramatically different, quite destroyed as it were." A figure in the image of his daughter is of course now long dead, has come back to talk to him. He realizes that he's been living this loop again and again and again. The primal loop that we've seen this season, they've been repeating, testing every time for what they're calling fidelity, or perhaps a deviation. You get the sense that the testing will continue. It's teasing for us another temporal realm that one day we're working toward, and one day we will see a little bit more of, and how they get to that place and what they're testing for. That's not all Lisa says, however. When asked if it would be accurate to refer to this version of the Man in Black as more along the lines of what he was testing with James Delos earlier this season, her answer is, "Yeah, we just get that it's not his original incarnation. That version of him that was human would be somewhere lying dead, and this is some other version of himself now. He doesn't quite understand what." She ends with talking about how season 3 will focus more on Dolores and Bernard in the real world, and not this future timeline host William. But she does say the show will eventually get there. The question in my head that the show creators would obviously not answer is who is trying to have another version of William brought into their time. Since Lisa Joy said that this scene was far into the future, I would assume it would be another host, since they would be the only characters we would recognize because of their whole not aging perks. What this all means is the shit that William went through this season is a defining character moment for him, similar to how James Delos' last conversation with his son Logan was for him, and I'm sure it has something to do with him killing his own daughter. But damn, this season's post-credit scene really outdid last season's, where we saw Armistice go berserk and cut her own arm off to escape, which was an awesome badass scene in itself. The show is really proving to be something special. I was a little worried when this season first started, with all the slow moments, but by the end I loved it. They keep coming up with the craziest twists and perfect dialogue. I'm gonna keep making more Westworld videos because it's quickly become one of my favorite shows of all time. Hope this video was enjoyable and cleared some things up for you. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys later.